Hey, how's everybody doing? My name's Lex Coop, and I'm back, and I'm going to bring you a breakdown of Far Cry 3 multiplayer. I'm playing TDM on Hideout. Alright, first thing I'm going to get to is the loadout. Now, you get to pick different classes, as many as you want. I don't know the actual cap, because I've went through and I've made like 15 or 20, and there's just keeps going. There's going to be obviously a cap at some point, but I'm not quite sure at this time what it is. This is the gun I'm using. The STG-90 with no mods. Now there are mods you can put on the gun and it gives the gun a special ability. I'm using suppressor with extended mags. Now there's a few different attachments you can use for each gun. Secondary, I'm using the 44 Magnum. I'm using battlecry, vest, landmines, and two other skill abilities. Okay, what I wanted to show you guys here is a few things on the HUD. Down here you can see the mini-map. It's pretty plain. It's pretty obvious what it is. There's people around you, your teammates. You can see them. They pop up in blue. You are white. Enemies pop up in red when they show up, whether they show up from firing or whether your teammates bring out some scouts. On the left here, this is your health meter. You can see how well you're doing and if you're about to die. All right, this is your points meter. It tells you how many points you've accumulated and it tells you how close you are to getting your next point streak. Now, there's three different point streaks. There's scouts, poisonous gas, and exploding barrels. In order to get scouts and call them in, the meter has to completely fill up. And then in order to get gas, poisonous gas, that meter has to fill up. And in order to get, well, you get the point. Meters have to fill up. There's a good side and a downside to the way they've dealt with their point system. How it works is every time you get points, it moves up the meter. That's plainly obvious. What isn't obvious is when you die, you don't lose all your points. All you lose is a small percentage. I think it takes off like 150 to 200 points, just basically for one or two kills. So it's good because that way you get to, if you die, you get to continue on with your point streak. Now, a lot of people are going to say that's bad. The way they balance it out is because if you call in your scouts, it completely gets rid of all the point streaks. Once you've surpassed scouts and you've earned your poisonous gas, you cannot just call in your scouts. You have to call in the poisonous gas or wait till you get to the exploding barrels. Once you get the exploding barrels, you cannot call in your poisonous gas and you cannot call in your scouts. And once you call in one, it gets rid of everything. So say you get completely full on poisonous gas, you call it in, you lose everything and you start back at the bottom and you try and get your scouts again. Over on the right here, you can see this is your ammo. This is your backup ammo and this is your clip ammo. And right here is your battle cry. When you use your battle cry, what it does is it affects the teammates around you and you gather points for that, which goes towards your point streaks. Now, how you call in your battle cry is you're pressing down on both joysticks. So if I called it in right now, I would get points according to people that are around me, and I would boost all of them. Some of the battle cries increase their health regeneration speed, and sometimes it just gives them a little bit of health. Now, I hope you guys enjoyed the Far Cry 3 HUD multiplayer breakdown. Now, if you guys want to see more, let me know in the comment section below. This is Lex Coop saying, rate, comment, subscribe, dooch, doosh, skadoosh.
Fuck you, man. You're not people. You are fucking animals. That's what you are, animals. Filthy pieces of... What? I'm going to live.